Hello everyone, this is Amit. Welcome to another video about Notepad++. Today we are going to learn top 6 dark themes in Notepad++. Notepad++ comes with many different themes, but today we are going to focus on dark themes, and I'll give you my top 6 dark themes in Notepad++ and also give you a preview of how they look in HTML and CSS and some of the other programming languages. So let's get started. So the very first theme that I really like is Zenburn, and let's take a look at how it looks. So go to settings, preferences, go to settings, style configurator, sorry about that. And on your top left, there is an option to select themes. So by default is just a white background and a default settings, but we are going to go all the way at the end in Zenburn, and I'm going to save and close. So this is how it looks in just a plain text file. But if I go to a Python script, this is how it looks. I can zoom in to see how it looks. Go to a C example. So this is just a C language, a file in C. And then I have a JavaScript, and this is how it looks. As I select, it actually looks like this. It just puts a faint grayish when you actually select a particular code block. And this is how it looks in CSS, if you have a CSS file. It looks pretty good. It has a nice black line number column and a pretty clean looking interface. This is for PHP, so all your comments are in green and so on. So this is not completely dark, it's a little grayish dark background. So that's my number one. Zenburn is the theme name. The next one is Twilight. So let's change to Twilight theme. So go to settings, style configurator. This time we are going to pick Twilight, right? And as the name suggests, it's a little more darker, and it looks fairly similar to Zenburn actually, but it has just a darker background to it. So this is a C. Actually, I closed Python, so I'm going to open that. Yep. So this is how the Python script might look like. As I select, as you can see, there's a grayish selection, you know, bar that you can see. This JavaScript, and this is how the CSS will look like. Actually, I should bring a HTML code also, so let me do that. An example HTML. So this is how the HTML page may look like in Twilight theme, and this is your Python script, and then this is the PHP. So again, it's pretty similar to Zenburn, but it's a little more darker background. But it looks pretty neat. All right, so the third one is Deep Black. And let's take a look at that. So go to Settings, Style Configurator, and Deep Black. So I don't know if you guys noticed, but the font was a little different from what we had in previous time. So let me go back, go to settings, style configurator. It did change the font style. Previously it was Consolas, I think. Now it's Courier New, which is a pretty common, I think by far the most common font. And I might make another video about changing the fonts and so on. But this is changed to Courier New. And this is how the plain text file looks like. And then this has a more of a retro kind of a feeling to it, this theme, Deep Black. The greens are a little more greener, oranges and stuff. And so this is a C, this is JavaScript. A little too dark for me, but it's pretty good. And this is a little bit of CSS. And again, as more retro kind of a feeling. If you are used to working in a console, you might like this Deep Black theme. So looks neat. And then this is how the Python script looks like, and then this is my HTML. All right, so we are at number four. Number four is Obsidian. And all these six themes that I have selected is already come installed, so you don't need to install a new theme. There are a lot more out there, and I may make a video out of just something that are out there, but this is already installed, so you don't need to do a special installation. As long as you have a pretty new version of Notepad++, I'm using Notepad++ version 7.9.1. All right, so let's go back to settings, style configurator, and this time we are going to use Obsidian. And as you can see, it is a little lighter, still dark theme, but just a little lighter blue, grayish kind of a color. So this is how it looks in C. This is your JavaScript, CSS, and then this is the PHP sample or a preview, and this is the Python script, and this is an example of HTML. Now the reason why I did this video is many times I want to try some different theme, and I would like to know how it will look like when I open a different kind of file, and so that is the reason I'm previewing all these themes in different kind of files, as a C and JavaScript, CSS, HTML, PHP, so that you guys can see what you're going to try it out. All right, so last two, we are at number five, and that's the next one is a mono industrial. So I'll go back to settings, style configurator, and there is a mono industrial. So this is just a minor change, but actually changing themes or selecting themes is really a personal preference, you know. Something that I like may not like by somebody else. So in general, Zenbun and some of the themes that I've selected is a pretty common across the board. But this is your, which one was this? This is mono industrial. So CSS, a little more purplish, which is interesting color, and then this is PHP, and then Python. It's just a little too darker, as you can see. The comments are almost similar to the background, so maybe it's okay. And then this is HTML, but definitely more purplish taint to it. So that's mono industrial, and the last one is a blackboard. And as it name suggests, it'll be much more deeper blacks. So black. Actually, it's more. It has a little bit of blue and tint to it. But this is your C and JavaScript, CSS. This is a PHP one, Python, and this is an HTML. So that's about it. These are my top six dark themes that are already installed in Notepad++. I'm sure you will like one of these, and there are some other ones out there, and I might make a video out of it. But give it a try. This is, if you like darker themes, some of these are pretty cool looking. So thank you very much. If you guys made it to this far, please make sure that you subscribe to my challenge channel, or at least like this video. And if you would like to see a particular kind of video in Notepad++, please comment in comment section. Thank you. Bye.